Hey guys, it's Jilli, and today I am going to be customizing a clipboard. So I'm going to start by taping off some areas. I'm using this thing called frog tape, but it's just painter's tape. So I'm taping off these sides because they actually have rulers on them. 1 centimeter is 1 inch. And I just want to keep those rulers. Oh, there's my head. I just want to keep the rulers because I think that's actually very helpful. You can measure like paper, I don't know, anything else that you would use on the clipboard. So I'm just using this knife I have. It's a pocket knife, and I'm just trying to make clean edges with the tape, so when I paint over it, I get clean edges. Right now, I'm mixing my paint. I have a navy, a purple, an island blue, and a bright blue color. So I'm just mixing that to get a nice dark blue, I don't know, color, and it's actually really pretty. So as I'm mixing this, I am also thinking of my design that I'm going to make after. So I'm using Posca paint pens to make my design, but for now, it's painting time. So as you can see right now, I was hesitating to paint that metal part, but then I decided not to because it's really easy just to wipe it off. So as I'm painting this, as you can see, this is a plastic clipboard. So it's very hard to get an even coverage. So I had to do like 3 layers, and it takes forever to dry. And you really have to start at the top or else it leaves smudge marks where you started. You'll see that as I get more into it. It also just comes off really easily. So right now I'm actually on my second coat, and I did not put enough paint in, so I had to mix it several times. So it came out a slightly different color every time. This light color was really light because when I poured the island blue color in, the light blue, it actually spilled so much. Anyway, so this last color that I got was actually a lot lighter, but I actually liked it. So that just lightened the whole thing up and made a little more bluish, not as much purple. And I finished this side by wiping up that metal part just to get it nice and clean. Then I started the back side by taking off the tape just on that side because when you flip it over and take the tape off, the underneath is going to show the green part, and I don't want any of the green to show, especially where I put the tape. So now I'm just continuing to add more paint on. As you may be able to tell from now, the back side was a lot harder to cover than the front side. It was just like more slippery and the paint wasn't sticking to it as well. I probably should have sanded the surface because it is smooth, but I didn't think of that in the moment. I just really wanted to paint something. And as you can see, I'm finishing up here. I did cover the metal bumps in the back. Now this is the satisfying part. I'm taking off the tape. So now I've come up with the design, and I'm just tracing some things so I can have perfect circles. So I'm making flowers, or like half flowers, I guess you could say. So then I cut this paper out, and it's a leaf petal. So all of my leaves are the exact same size. And as I'm doing this, I decided I wanted to use my Posca paint pens. So I started filling in the space, but the Posca paint pens started ripping up the underpaint or the base layer. So I decided to use some CraftSmart paint instead. So here I am just filling in the flower with this CraftSmart paint that worked a lot better than the Posca paint pens because the Posca paint pens are so small that it was going to take forever to go in. So then I had a little leaf and I decided to use my pink for that, and it worked okay. And then I used my orangey red pastel one for the next leaf, and that didn't work as well and it didn't get an even coat. Then I decided to paint the whole thing with just acrylic paint because the Posca paint pens would not work for what I had in mind. But then I decided that I was going to put some Posca paint pens on the outside for like a little layer and outline. So then on my next flower, I decided to do a pink, blue, and purple color. So on these, I'm going to have to do several coats because the pink does not go well over this blue. On the next flower, I decided to do a warm color scheme because on the last flower, I did a sort of cooler one. So now I'm painting the third and final flower, and my paintbrush broke, and I think it's because it was in the water for so long. Anyways, I'm painting the main part of the flower orange, which isn't really in contrast between the other two, because the other two are like pink and yellow, and those are all like in the same like... Oh. Whoops. Well, I'm just realizing that now. But I started by painting the first petal red, and the other petals, I decided I didn't want the same colors as, like, the rainbow flower, so I decided to mix a few colors for the other petals. So that's the first coat, and this is the second. Now, I started to outline all of the petals and the centers with Posca paint pens, and I didn't know if I wanted the same color or a different color or a lighter outline. So I started with going with an outline that was very similar in color, and then I changed to going with an outline that was lighter in color. So I think that helped to make them pop a little more. And that second clip there was just me getting more organized because I had a bunch of my Posca paint pens in different orders and I didn't know which set went to which. So that's why I changed. And that one petal by the pink one was very, very hard to get to. I couldn't get the right color, but in the end, I thought it went pretty well. Now, that really cool trick right there was me deciding what color to do for the light blue on the biggest flower. And I decided to go with the middle blue because I thought that looked good on this color. Now I am starting to add a layer of Mod Podge and glue. So I used the gloss Mod Podge, which does leave a little bit of a sticky side. So that's why I mixed it with some glue all, Elmer's glue, just to make it a little less sticky because paper's going to be on there. So I just Mod Podged the entire thing. So when I Mod Podged the back, I couldn't find my paint palette, so I just used the top of this vanilla yogurt container. And don't go away yet, because I have a really cool magic trick right now. Whoa, I finished it. And are you ready for the final thing? Because here it is. I love it so much. That's a little bit of Mod Podge still on the back. It doesn't scratch, and it doesn't peel off, and it still works. And I just love it so much. I love the colors. I signed it in the corner. I just love it so much. And now I feel like I need a model for you. Just so you know it works. So I put some paper. And I'm going to write a little message to you guys. Yeah? Subscribe? Maybe. Yeah, so I am just super happy with the result of this. And I can't wait to do another video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Bye!